This video is going to be a bit of a random one. The latest update for No Man's Sky arrived unexpectedly last week. The new patch, called Prisms, brings a whole lot to the game, including a great looking graphics overhaul. So, why do I say this video is going to be a bit random? Well, I really wanted to take a few moments to just talk about Hello Games and put my thoughts out there on the work they've been doing. The last few years have been a very weird time for gaming. We've kind of got to the point in history of games developments now where botched releases aren't merely the norm, but they're also kind of expected. I mean, you only really have to look around Reddit, YouTube comments and random forums to see that there's a whole load of people out there now that view this as no longer a case of if a new game is going to be broken, but rather how badly it will be broken. When it comes to failed releases then, No Man's Sky is right up there. Yet anyone looking for it for the first time today would, well, likely never guess at its history. In 2014, the first No Man's Sky trailer caught the imagination of the world. Well, at least I know it caught my imagination, and in no small part because of its unique visual flair. Being heavily inspired by sci-fi art of the 60s, 70s and 80s, it instantly had a natural appeal to me. We all know the story though, the hype train went to the moon, and when it arrived, the moon wasn't there. The explosion within the gaming industry was instant and more or less unprecedented. No Man's Sky simply didn't deliver anywhere close to its promises, and not only that, but it was badly broken as well. Hello Games took a lot of heat for this, and the thing is, ever since then, it hasn't been a lone example. There's been many cases of it happening again and again. Of course, Fallout 76 and Cyberpunk 2077 are very high-profile examples. There's also been many others, many of them quite recently. That's not to say that No Man's Sky was the first time this happened. It goes right back over the years, over the decades, right back even to the release of E.T. on the 8-bit computers or home entertainment systems. So not a new thing, but I really think with No Man's Sky, it was kind of an unprecedented impact, very, very large in how it all happened. Now, most of these titles, recent ones especially, kind of pick themselves up along the way. There's people out there now who will tell you that Fallout 76 is a decent game. CD Projekt Red, meanwhile, have done a lot of work to improve Cyberpunk. Yet these titles now have a stigma that has remained with them, a bad air that they just cannot fully shake off. And we've all seen the share value for CD Projekt Red very recently, which has taken a bit of a nosedive, shall we say. But it's really interesting to me then that Hello Games have managed to not only fully redeem themselves, but also exceed many people's expectations. Sure, there's some people that will never forgive Hello Games, but honestly, there's always that type. I don't want to recount the history of No Man's Sky or Hello Games in this video though. Really, it's simply that I feel Hello Games have done such a fantastic job that I wanted to literally point out that I genuinely respect what they have achieved. I can't really imagine how the launch reaction must have made Sean Murray and the others at Hello Games feel. I know there's people that will feel at least some of that reaction was justified. The negative reviews, the poor video reactions, the general exasperation. We see that type of thing often with poor games, and to be honest, it seems just a part of the process, rightly or wrongly. But for Hello Games, it went to an entirely different level with targeted harassment, threats, and essentially becoming the butt of ongoing jokes. Hello Games and No Man's Sky were the real story of how to not do things. Yet, years later, they are the true comeback story. They can genuinely and honestly be cited as a prime example of how to recover from a bad situation caused by bad decisions. In my opinion, Hello Games made the right move with this very early on, when they eventually admitted to their mistakes. Not an easy thing, and yes, they didn't do it immediately. It was a risky move, perhaps, but they did eventually do it nonetheless. What's more, they admitted to their mistakes without spin. Since then, they've listened to the community, taken feedback on board, and consistently delivered amazing updates that often surprise people and nearly always please them. For me then, what I respect about Hello Games isn't that they put their heads down and went radio silent between updates. It might have worked for No Man's Sky, and it still does work for No Man's Sky, but it probably wouldn't work for live service games or full MMOs, where the players, quite rightly, expect constant feedback from the developers. No, what I respect is that Hello Games owned their mistake without spin. Today, they are very willing to discuss the issues without corporate PR nonsense, they're even willing to joke about it. They've moved on from their mistake in just about every way possible. To me, that is an amazing achievement and something that I just wanted to point out that I have immense respect for. At the end of the day, whether you like No Man's Sky as a game or dislike it, it's impossible to deny that Hello Games made an amazing recovery. And the latest update, Prisms, is another testament to that. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys and girls next time.